President, please be seated.
Veuillez vous asseoir.
The
court is now in session.
Ouverture de
l'audience. Today, the chamber continues to hear testimony of witness Saint-Sac.
La chambre poursuivra l'audition du témoin Saint-Sac.
And begins to hear testimony of a civil party
that is to
TCCP 241. Miss Jesse Juan, please report the attendance of the parties and other individuals to today's proceedings. Gracias, Mr. President, for today's proceedings, all parties to discuss are present.
Toutes les parties à l'audience sont
présentes. Mr. Nunchi is present.
Nunchi, lui,
in the holding cell downstairs, he has waived his right to be
temporaire du tribunal. Il a
present in the courtroom. The waiver has been delivered to the greffier.
Le document s'était fait et remis.
The witness who is to conclude her testimony today, that is Madame Saussac, is present in the courtroom.
Et dans la salle d'audience.
We also have a reserved civil party today, that is to TCCP 241.
De TCCP 241.
President, thank you.
Le président.
And before I
Merci.
Hand the floor to the parties to put questions to this witness, I'll provide the oral ruling.
De poursuivre avec l'interrogatoire de ce témoin, la Chambre va rendre une décision orale telle que l'avait demandé la défense de Nunchi.
The chamber has received a waiver from Nunchi dated 7 December 2015, which says that due to his health, he cannot sit or concentrate for long. And in order to effectively participate in future hearings,
Nunchi ne peut demeurer ainsi pendant trop longtemps
to participate in and be present.
Suivre les débats depuis la cellule temporaire pour le 7 décembre 2015.
That his counsel has advised him about the consequences
of the waiver,
that it cannot in any
account
be construed as a waiver of his right to be tried fairly, or to challenge evidence presented
to or admitted by this court at any time during this trial. Une renonciation de son droit à procès équitable et à contester les preuves présentées à charge contre lui.
Having seen the medical report of Nunchi by the duty daughter for the accused,
la chambre est aussi saisie d'un rapport du médecin des CETC en date du 7 décembre 2015. Le médecin a examiné Nunchi et souligne que
back pain when he sits for long, and recommends that the chamber grant him his request so that he can follow the proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs. Based on the above information,
par ces motifs et en application de la règle 81.5 du règlement intérieur des CETC, la chambre fait droit à la demande de Nunchia pour suivre les débats à distance
from the holding
cell temporaire du tribunal
via audiovisuel. The chamber instructs the AV unit personnel
de raccorder la cellule temporaire au prétoire par les moyens audiovisuels de sorte à ce que Nunchi puisse suivre les débats pour toute la journée.
To the whole day. And now the chamber hands the floor to the co-prosecutor to put questions to the witness. And the combined time for both the co-prosecutors and the lead co-lawyers for civil parties is 1 second. You may proceed.
Thank you. Good morning, Your Honors, Counsel, civil parties, and Madam Witness. Madam Witness, I want to continue to ask you about some other people from your village and area that you may or may not know, and whether you had information, either saw or heard information about their fate. And tell us, continue to tell us if you do have information or if you don't. You mentioned, I asked you late on Thursday about Khun Mong and his wife. You said you knew them, but you didn't know her fate. Do you know what happened to Khun Mong's wife's mother,
Lee Tihai,
and her siblings?
Et sa fratrie.
Witness.
Le témoin.
Which mom are you referring to?
À quel mom
are you referring to Mon Hu?
Is Mon Hu?
It's not clear to me.
Thank you. I'm referring to Khun Mon,
who had a wife
who was had a Chinese father, Seng, and a Vietnamese mother, Li Tihai. The name of the wife was Seng Por. Do you recall that gentleman?
Yes, I recall that Seng Hu lived near where I lived, and she married Mon and went to live in Swai Amtor commune. However, I did not know about the situation involving their family since they moved to live with her husband in another commune.
Have you ever seen the wife or her mother, that's Khun Mon's mother-in-law, or the wife's siblings since the Democratic Kampuchea regime?
Et ses frères et sœurs depuis la fin du régime du Kampuchea démocratique.
We separated after that, that is, after she got married
après
and left
son
the village.
Et qu'elle a quitté le village, nous
yes,
nous étions séparés.
My question is, question. All these years later,
mais j'aimerais savoir
have
si
you
tout
ever seen or heard from her?
Ce temps, l'avez-vous revu ou avez-vous entendu
since 1979.
Depuis 1979. Réponse.
No, since we separated, I never saw her returning to visit the village.
Vu revenir au village.
Khun Mon question. Said this in a article that's E3/2589, based on his interview with DC Cam.
Donc, dans son interview avec le CD Cam, Khun Mon a dit
he said out page. In Khmer 0022-4670, in French 0062-33-48, and in English 0022-4673, that it was only later that he came to understand the reasons for his wife's arrest. If a person was related by blood to a Vietnamese, they would be killed. He mentioned his brother-in-law, Seng Ban, as an example. All of his family members were killed except a son named Mao, who hid in a cornfield and survived. Khun Mon's relatives and neighbors report that they knew of no mistakes anyone had made, but that Vietnamese wives and children were killed. Mon's mother-in-law, Li Tihai, sister-in-law, Seng Tian, and brother-in-law, Seng Ke, were also killed. Do you have any information about that after hearing that? Is that?
Avez-vous des informations à ce sujet?
Do you recall anything else
que
you could add?
Vous lire? Vous souvenez-vous de quelque chose que vous pourriez ajouter?
Regarding Ihai family, I only know one who was the father, and he had his wife, a Vietnamese wife, and the children were taken away and killed. I do not know anything about the mother, that is Mon Phu, since we separated.
Depuis que
and
nous
I
avons
only
été séparés.
Know about one Mao, as I just told you earlier.
Je ne connais que
okay, thank you. So let me move on then.
Je ne connais qu'un seul Mao, comme je vous l'ai dit tout à l'heure. Le procureur, très bien.
And ask you about a few other persons who were named by Khun Mon. And this is at E3-5325. 0082-41-84 in English.
84.
In
Khmer,
it's 0045-51-643.
64
and in French,
00 86 92 84.
Did you know someone, a new person called
Taprun,
who had a dark complexion and a Vietnamese wife? Does that ring a bell to you?
Une femme vietnamienne. Est-ce que cela vous dit quelque chose?
Réponse. No, I do not know Taprun. I do not know which village he lives in.
Okay. One more name going to the next page in all three languages. I might need my colleague to pronounce it.
Lac Ni is the name.
You know that person?
I do not know Lac Li. I do not know which village this person lives in.
Now, then I'm going to move on and ask you about some other names mentioned by a woman named
Yin Mui. Yin
Mui.
The name.
The name is Jim Mui. Jim.
And that document is E3-7783. Before I ask you these questions, just to see if you know this person, apparently the family had lived in An Lang Tria in the 1960s. Her mother's name was Ai and was mixed race Vietnamese. Do you know this woman at all?
I am really not sure. Is Mui the daughter of Grandma Hai?
La fille de Ye Hai?
Yes.
Okay, réponse. Le procureur, oui. Réponse.
I know that Mui.
Oui, je connais cette Mui.
She got married and moved to live in Crohum.
Elle est allée vivre à Crohum.
However, she later on passed away and she had her children still living in Phnom Penh.
Ses enfants habitent à Phnom Penh.
Do you know what happened to her younger brother,
savez-vous
Guy,
ce qui est arrivé?
Younger
son
sister,
frère cadet Guy,
Tieng,
sa soeur cadette
and
Tieng,
her mother,
et sa mère,
Hai, and her younger sister,
et sa soeur cadette aussi, Hu.
We separated after 1979, so I don't know about her family situation, and we have never met since.
Et nous ne nous sommes jamais revus.
I only knew that Hu was killed, and after that I have not received any news from this family.
Je n'ai plus jamais reçu de nouvelles de cette famille.
Okay, let me read then from the statement that she gave, and in Khmer, this is at page 00238898, in French 00281807, and in English 00242416. She stated that in approximately 1977, she went to transplant rice seedlings. All seven of her children lived in the house as normal. Her husband was a tailor in Shre Krahom village.
Marie était un tailleur.
She says once a day during that same year, a man named An,
Chok An,
a villager, at Po Riang village,
au village de Po Riang,
who went back and forth between there and Sva and Tor village,
entre cet endroit et Sva,
told her husband, all of your wife's family have been taken and killed.
Toute la famille de sa femme avait
those
été
killed were his
exécutés.
Followers.
Les personnes tuées étaient
Nimoy's
les suivants.
Younger brother,
le jeune
Guy,
frère Guy,
younger sister Tiang,
Tiang
were working in a mobile unit, were killed first.
Mobile, ils ont été tués en premier.
Her mother Hai,
sa mère, Hai,
her younger sister
sa soeur, Hu, cadette,
Hu, the wife of Kun Mong,
l'épouse de Kun Mong,
and three nieces and nephews were killed two or three days later. Do you have any information about that, other than I believe you told us you heard about one brother?
Je crois que vous nous avez dit que vous aviez entendu parler d'un des frères.
I did not with them, so I cannot tell you anything else. I lived in a different village. They lived in Po Riang, while I lived in Longtree, which was far. Even Mon in Svan Tho, although it was closer, but I could not go there. And during the Khmer Rouge regime, we were prohibited from going to another village. Every morning when we woke up, we had to go to the website.
Thank you very much. Thank you for explaining to us what you do know and do not know.
De nous expliquer ce que vous savez,
I want to
ce que
ask
vous
you then,
pas.
I believe, just about one more
donc, je crois
statement.
Que encore une and this is from vous citer.
A ce sont les person who now would be in his 70s, named Mon Chui.
70 ans, du nom
his
de
wife's
Chui.
Name Nieng Pan.
Son épouse s'appelle Nieng Han.
Mom. The name is Mom Choi.
Il s'appelle Mom Choi. And Ling Kang.
Pan.
Ling Pan.
Those people. Do you know Mom Choi?
Question. Donc.
Yum.
Connaissez-vous?
No, that name does
non.
not ring a bell.
Ce
I don't know which village the person
rien,
lives
ne
in.
Saurais pas vous dire dans quel village.
Did you know a midwife? In Anlang Treya village,
question.
Named Yea Doich.
Smo Yea Da. The name is Yea Da.
Elle s'appelle
Yea Da.
There
were two Yea Ba and Yea Da.
Back et Duck,
Duck was the mother of
Duck
Ba, who was a
Ba,
midwife and she actually saved her, the lives of many people there.
La vie de beaucoup de gens là.
She mostly saved villagers in Anlong Tree and in other villages through her midwifery practice.
Grâce à sa pratique de sage-femme.
And the knowledge passed on from the mother to the daughter.
De passer de mère en fille.
However, she was taken away and
mais
killed, and
et
nobody
tuée.
Knew that she was taken away and killed.
Personne ne
only
savait
later on, we learned that her house was empty and nobody
a vu
was
que
there.
Sa maison était vide.
Was her ethnicity?
Question inaudible du procureur.
This woman that was taken away and killed.
Cette personne a été emmenée et tuée.
She was Vietnamese originally.
Elle était vietnamienne.
And when, since I grew up, I saw her living in a village,
et
although
quand
I
grandi,
did not know
dans le village.
Where she originally came from. However, as I said, she saved many lives in my village.
Beaucoup de vie dans
and the lives that she saved, were those people all Vietnamese?
Sauvé,
what was the ethnicity of those whose lives she saved?
Quelle était la nationalité ou l'ethnicité plutôt de ces personnes qu'elle a sauvées? Réponse.
Regardless of a Vietnamese or Khmer ethnicity, whoever came
Khmer,
to her for help, she would save them all.
Aide, elle,
Do you recall any period of time when the local cadres from your area, Prevang, were replaced by cadres from another part of Cambodia?
Par des cadres qui venaient d'un autre endroit, au Cambodge, d'une autre région du Cambodge.
No, I don't.
Réponse, non.
I saw them coming, but I did not know from where they came.
J'ai vu qu'ils sont venus, mais je ne savais pas
d'où
ils venaient.
I was an ordinary villager.
J'étais
I only saw them, and I did not dare even look at their face, let alone asking them where they came.
Je ne sûrement pas demandé. Je n'allais sûrement pas leur
demander. Can you explain a bit about what happened when you say you saw them coming?
Pouvez-vous nous dire ce what happened que cela when these other people came? Que s'est-il passé lorsqu'ils sont arrivés?
We were not allowed to actually meet them, and I spent most of my time in a rice field, and I only returned to the village for lunch at 11:30, so I did not know about their activities.
Did these people speak with the same accent as those from your village, or with a different accent?
I did not meet them and did not hear what they said.
Je ne les ai pas rencontrés, je n'ai pas
I met only those from Anlung Tria commune, so only the people from those communes that I knew that they were Khmer.
The disappearance of those who were Vietnamese or part Vietnamese that we've talked about over since Thursday, did this occur, if you know, continue to occur after these people arrived or not? Do you know?
Yes, they disappear one after another. And when the Vietnamese were about to liberate, and then there were no more disappearances.
Thank you, Mr. President. I turn over the witness to the civil parties. Thank you very much. Thank you, Madam Witness.
Thank you.
Merci, Madame le témoin.
The President, thank you. The lead lawyer for the civil party, you may now proceed.
Merci. Quoi avocat pour les parties civiles, vous avez la parole.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you, Mr. President,
bonjour à tous.
And good morning
bonjour,
to all
Madame
of you.
Le
good
témoin.
Morning, Miss Witness.
Je m'appelle Marie Giraud, je représente
and I represent,
le collectif des partis civils.
Parties,
j'ai quelques très, très courtes questions to à vous poser. Des questions de précision par rapport à ce que vous nous avez expliqué jeudi dernier. Vous nous avez expliqué jeudi dernier qu'il y avait des enfants métis et des enfants de mariage mixte au sein de votre village à Anlung Tria. Je voulais savoir si on pouvait reconnaître physiquement les enfants mixtes ou métis, et si oui, quelles étaient les caractéristiques physiques qui permettaient de différencier ces enfants des autres enfants.
I knew only about those in Anlung Tria village. Some had wife and some had children, and I knew about them. I did not know about those living in other village. I knew only those in my village. Like Van Mao, he had a Khmer wife, and I knew that he's a mixed blood. And his child, he brought from Vietnam, so I knew that
Vietnam,
she's ethnic Vietnamese, so I knew only those in my village. I did not know about those in other villages.
Je vous remercie. Je ne vais vous poser des questions que sur ce qui s'est passé dans votre village, à Anang Tria, uniquement. Je voulais savoir s'il était possible de reconnaître physiquement les personnes qui étaient mixtes ou vietnamiennes et les personnes qui étaient khmères au sein de votre village. Est-ce qu'elles ressemblaient, est-ce qu'elles étaient similaires d'apparence physique ou est-ce qu'elles étaient différentes?
They had dark complexions,
and I,
I knew that they had either ethnic father who is Vietnamese or mother who is Khmer.
Quand vous dites qu'ils étaient plutôt foncés, vous parlez des enfants métis ou des enfants de parents Khmer?
Métis children or children whose parents were Khmer.
I refer to their parents. If their parents are with ethnic Vietnamese, we say that oh, they children of Vietnamese. So it's what we heard from one another. So people in my village said about that. So it's what people in the village said.
Juste sur cette question de couleur de peau dont vous avez parlé, pour bien comprendre votre propos, est-ce que les enfants métis, donc qui avaient des parents vietnamiens, avaient la peau plus claire ou plus foncée que les autres, ou est-ce qu'ils avaient la même couleur de peau?
Were they more dark-skinned than the others, or they had the same skin color?
If talking about their skin, for example, I myself, I look like my mother, so I had white skin. But like Wan Mao, he had dark complexion.
He
looked like his father. So it doesn't mean that only those who has white skin
are
ethnic Vietnamese children. It did not mean like that.
C'est très clair, je vous remercie. Comment dès lors pouvait-on savoir au sein même du village qui avait un ou des parents vietnamiens et qui avait des parents
Khmer?
Comment cela se passait-il au sein du village de Anlong Treya pour savoir qui avait des origines vietnamiennes et qui n'en avait pas?
In my opinion, I thought that the village chief also did some report about the ethnicity of the villagers. But for me, in my village, I knew those who had Vietnamese wife or Vietnamese husbands.
But
in the village chief, I think they may have done some report about the ethnicity of the villagers. That's why
people
in the higher ranking in the Anka, they knew something about the ethnicity of the people in the village.
Au courant de l'ethnie des gens du village.
So
I
knew about when they got married to ethnic Khmer, and then their history was known to the villagers, and people talk about that, and that's what all I knew about.
Quand vous dites que vous pensez que le chef du village faisait un rapport, est-ce que c'est quelque chose dont vous aviez entendu parler à l'époque, qu'il y avait des rapports ou qu'il y avait des listes?
Is that something you heard of during that period, that there were reports written by the chief?
Mr. President,
thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honours. I wanted to make the observation already a little bit earlier because I heard the witness say when she was answering the previous question, in my opinion, the village chief may have done certain things. I understand the follow-up question, but I think maybe it would be in the benefit of for all parties that the witness be instructed only to say the things that she actually knows, rather than giving her opinion on what might have been the case.
C'était précisément le sens de ma question, Monsieur le Président. Je voulais que le témoin réagisse pour nous dire ce qu'elle savait à l'époque et non pas ce qu'elle croyait savoir. Donc c'était précisément le sens de ma question. Je pense que je suis pour le coup en phase avec ce que nous indique notre confrère. Donc, Madame le témoin, est-ce que vous saviez à l'époque qu'il y avait des rapports établis par le chef du village? Est-ce que c'est une information que vous connaissiez à l'époque?
Is that information that you had in your possession?
When they did the report they did about the ethnic Khmer, I did not know about the ethnic Vietnamese.
Vous nous avez parlé de votre mère jeudi, et vous nous avez indiqué que votre mère était métisse.
And you said that
moitié vietnamienne, je voulais savoir si votre mère parlait la langue vietnamienne, le vietnamien.
Did your mother speak the Vietnamese language?
She did not speak Vietnamese, but when Vietnamese people talked to her, she understood.
Depuis jeudi, vous nous parlez d'autres personnes métisses qui habitaient à An Lang Tria. Est-ce que vous savez si ces personnes parlaient le vietnamien ou non, à l'époque, bien sûr?
Tria. Do you know whether those persons spoke Vietnamese during that period?
They did not speak Vietnamese since they were born. Métis until now, no one of them could speak Vietnamese.
Le vietnamien depuis leur naissance jusqu'à ce moment-là, ils ne parlaient pas vietnamien.
Je vous remercie. Vous nous avez expliqué jeudi, quand vous avez répondu au coprocureur national, que les Vietnamiens et les personnes métisses de votre village avaient été emmenés à un moment pour aller dans la partie basse du Cambodge, et puis vous nous avez dit qu'en fait ils avaient été renvoyés au Vietnam. Je voudrais vous lire ce que vous avez déclaré jeudi et vous poser une question par rapport à cela.
And put some questions to you.
Vous avez déclaré à 15h20, j'ai vu qu'ils ont été rassemblés et on les a évacués à la partie basse. Ceux qui venaient d'une famille mixte ont été rassemblés de façon continue et ont été envoyés par bateau. Dans le cas des familles mixtes, ils envoyaient une famille à la fois et ces familles ne cessaient de disparaître. Est-ce que vous vous souvenez avoir fait cette déclaration jeudi?
Do you remember making that statement on Thursday?
Yes, I did.
Oui.
Pouvez-vous expliquer à la cour comment, en tout cas dans vos souvenirs, comment ces personnes ont été rassemblées et évacuées? Quels sont les souvenirs que vous avez par rapport à ces événements?
What do you remember as regards those events?
They assembled people and were sent to somewhere. So each family were collected and sent away and they disappeared. And sometimes they were sent at night time, some at day time. I did not know much about this because I worked during the day. Only when people told me that they were sent away. So this is what I heard from people.
Est-ce que vous saviez à l'époque qui rassemblait ces gens? Est-ce qu'il s'agissait de cadres ou de miliciens de votre village, d'An Lang Tria, ou est-ce qu'il y avait des personnes de l'extérieur qui venaient pour se charger de cette évacuation? Est-ce que vous en avez le souvenir?
Do you remember anything about that?
I did not know who came to assemble people. I just only knew that people disappear.
Est-ce que vous avez entendu parler à un moment dans votre village, ou peut-être un peu plus large que votre village, de tests de langue qui étaient conduits pour savoir si les personnes parlaient vietnamien ou non? Est-ce que c'est quelque chose dont vous avez entendu parler à l'époque?
Il n'y avait pas de test de langue.
Vous nous avez indiqué jeudi que les personnes qui étaient rassemblées et qui étaient évacuées étaient évacuées vers le Vietnam. Comment avez-vous eu cette information? Et comment pouvez-vous dire aujourd'hui qu'ils avaient été évacués vers le Vietnam?
They were evacuated to Vietnam. On what basis can you say today that they were evacuated to Vietnam?
It's only what I heard from other people say that those people were sent to Vietnam.
Et ces personnes qui vous ont dit cela, c'était des personnes qui étaient au village de Hanh Long Tria à l'époque. Est-ce qu'à l'époque, les gens parlaient de cela au sein du village, que les personnes étaient évacuées vers le Vietnam, ou c'est quelque chose que vous avez appris plus tard, après la fin du Kampuchea démocratique?
It's what I heard from the villagers,
that those people were evacuated to Vietnam,
and they were sent back to their home country in Vietnam. So it's what people said.
Et ma dernière question, Madame le témoin, vous parlez des villageois qui vous auraient dit que ces personnes seraient retournées au Vietnam. Est-ce que vous avez à l'époque entendu parler de cela par un cadre ou un milicien de votre village, de ce que ces personnes étaient renvoyées vers le Vietnam? Je vous remercie, Madame le témoin. Je n'ai plus de questions, Monsieur le Président, et je souligne qu'en traduction française, je pense qu'il y a eu une erreur. Mais je peux peut-être du coup reposer la question au témoin. Vous avez indiqué, Madame le témoin, que vous aviez entendu dire des vieux du village que les Vietnamiens n'avaient pas le droit de vivre au Vietnam. Est-ce que c'est bien ça que vous avez déclaré, ou est-ce qu'il y a eu une erreur de traduction?
Were sent to live in Vietnam. That's only what I said. I did not say anything else. I said those who were evacuated because they were Vietnamese, so they needed to live in their country.
Parfait. Je vous remercie. Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Perfect. Thank you. I thank you, witness. Thank you, Mr. President.
Co-defense counsel for Nguyen Chia, you may now proceed.
La défense de Nguyen Chia a la parole.
President,
now I give the floor to Defense Counsel for the accused Nguyen Chi. You now may proceed with the questions.
Thank you, Mr. President, and good morning, Madam Witness. I have not many questions that I would like to put to you, only a few. I would like to start with the following question. You were born in 1953. That means that you were 17 years old in 1970. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct.
In the period between 1970 and 75, did you ever travel outside of your village? Did you, for instance, ever go to Phnom Penh between 70 and 75?
I did not leave my village during that time. I only live in my village in Long Tria.
Did you have family in Phnom Penh or Takiu, for instance?
No, I did not have.
Réponse: non, je n'avais pas.
Did you know what happened outside of your village
question, saviez-vous ce qu'il se passait à l'extérieur de votre village?
Between 1970 and 75, for instance, with people from Vietnamese ethnicity?
Ou ce qu'il arrivait aux personnes d'origine vietnamienne?
I did not know about that. I knew only
réponse, je n'en savais rien.
About the evacuation of those people, but I did not know about what happened
j'ai
outside the village.
À propos de l'évacuation de ces personnes, mais je ne savais pas ce qu'il se passait en l'extérieur du village. Question.
Have you ever heard your mother speak about mass executions of Vietnamese in 1970, or detention, arrest of many Vietnamese in 1970, a campaign with words against Vietnamese. Did you hear anything about that?
Contre les Vietnamiens, une campagne orale.
I did not know about that.
Let me go back to what you said on Thursday. At 14 hours 33 minutes, the question is, I think it was a question from the National Co-Prosecutor. Can you tell the court how the base people regarded Vietnamese people? Were there any differences in treatment on the Vietnamese people before 1975 and after 1975? And your answer is, I quote, before 75, we had a normal relationship. Later on, people were sorted out and Vietnamese people were sorted during the time. End of quote. Now, when you gave that answer on Thursday, did you mean, or did you limit your answer specifically only to people of Vietnamese origin in your village?
Limitiez votre réponse uniquement aux personnes d'origine vietnamienne dans votre village.
Okay.
Had no trouble in their relationship. When the ethnic Vietnamese were taken out, the ethnic Khmer also did not know much about what happened to them.
But when you gave your answer last Thursday to the question relating to the treatment of Vietnamese before 75, you were only limiting your answer to what you know that happened in your village. Is that correct?
In my village, there was also no strange event taking place.
Just to be sure, you have never heard of mass executions of Vietnamese during the Lon Nol regime. Is that correct?
Yes, I did not hear about it because it was not something to do with ordinary people, because ordinary people were busy with their living.
Let me give you one example. The mass execution of 800 Vietnamese laborers whose bodies were thrown in the Ba Sac River in 1970. Have you ever heard of such an event?
No, I did not hear about it. As I told you, that I was an ordinary people, so I thought only about how to earn a living for my family, and I was also fearful about the bombing at that time.
Have you ever heard on the radio that the Lon Nol government admitted to arresting some 30,000 Vietnamese and jailing 7,000 of them under the suspicion of treason?
No, I did not hear about that because my family was poor. We did not have a radio.
So I presume you also never heard anything of a mass execution of Vietnamese in Tak Kieu before 1975?
I did not hear about it.
Réponse, c'est exact.
Une requête, Monsieur le Président, peut-on avoir les références des documents sur lesquels notre confrère s'appuie pour poser ces questions?
Merci.
But of course, Mr. President, in accordance with the practice, I was first asking open questions, and then later on I would refer to my source. Allow me one last question, and then I will refer to where I have my knowledge from. Have you ever heard of anti-Chinese campaigns in Phnom Penh before 75? Chinese, or people of Chinese descent being threatened with mass execution. Have you ever heard of that?
No, I did not. I did not know at all.
Je ne savais pas du tout.
Mr. President, I was referring to a book from someone who the whom the court considers that she is an expert, the book of Elizabeth Becker, more specifically that is E3/20, ERN English 00237829 and 30, Khmer 00232165 and 66, and French 00638396 and 97, in which the author discusses the anti-Vietnamese pogroms, the anti-Vietnamese campaigns of Lon Nol, mass executions, mass detention, and a threat to the Chinese of having the same fate as the Chinese in Indonesia in 65, where they were massively executed by a Western, pro-Western government in Indonesia. That's where I have my questions from. But I understand, Madam Witness, that you do not know anything about the treatment of the Vietnamese before 1975, correct?
No, I did not know about this.
Réponse, non, je ne savais rien de cela.
Have you ever heard of something called, or a magazine, or a paper called Revolutionary Flag?
Intitulé Étendard révolutionnaire.
No, I never saw it.
Réponse, non.
I lived in the countryside and I never saw it.
Have you ever, between 75 and 79, listened to Radio Phnom Penh?
75 et 79, avez-vous jamais écouté Radio Phnom Penh?
Not during the regime, people were not allowed to know anything about the news.
D'écouter la radio, enfin d'avoir accès aux nouvelles.
But Radio Phnom Penh, I think, was the official broadcast organ of the Democratic Kampuchea government, so I think it was allowed for people to listen to Radio Phnom Penh.
Je pense qu'il était normal que les gens écoutent Radio Phnom Penh.
Did you ever listen to the radio, or did you know someone who listened to the radio?
Ou connaissez-vous Radio Phnom Penh more specifically? Qui écoutait des émissions de radio et plus spécifiquement des émissions de la station de Radio Phnom Penh?
No, I did not, as
non.
I said.
Comme je l'ai déjà dit.
In each family, we were only thinking of feeding our family members. We did nothing of politics.
Nous ne savions rien de la politique.
We were striving to earn the living for my children. There were seven children that I had who passed away.
Deux sont décédés.
So my main focus is
enfants,
to provide food.
Décédés. Moi, j'ai travaillé à fournir de la nourriture aux enfants et à la fin du régime, j'ai fait de mon mieux pour nourrir ma famille et surtout mes enfants.
I understand, Madam Witness. Is it then fair for me to say that the only encounter you ever had with functionaries of the Democratic Kampuchea government
or are your interactions with the local cadres from your village?
Are they the only representatives of the Democratic Kampuchea government that you spoke to or that you had contact with?
Avec lesquels vous avez eu des contacts? Réponse.
Only interacted with the cadres.
Je n'ai eu de contact qu'avec les cadres de mon village.
So would it then be
question.
Fair for me to say that you, at the time, had no idea
donc que à l'époque,
what the policy was of either the Democratic Kampuchea government
or the Communist Party of Kampuchea versus the Vietnamese? Au sujet des Vietnamiens.
Yes, that is correct. I did not know anything about that.
Je n'en savais rien.
Madam Witness, in your written record of interview, you refer to something that you call, quote unquote, the events of Sao Pim.
Les événements de Sao Pim.
Literally, you say on English page 0025511, Khmer
96 plutôt,
and French
0025060600.
As for me, I had to pull and transplant rice. Rice seedlings make fermented fish, smoke fish, mill rice, and pound rice according to the season. About 1 or 2 years later there were the events of Sao Pim, and the defeated soldiers and the wives of the former Lonel soldiers, along with those with tendencies, were rounded up and sent to the center and disappeared. And my question is specifically about the events of Sao Pim. What did you mean when you said that to the investigators? The events of Sao Pim.
Quand vous l'avez dit aux enquêteurs, quand vous avez parlé des événements de Sao Pim.
After the events of Sao Pim,
c'était comme ça qu'on l'appelait. Les soldats qui étaient retournés dans les villages ont été rappelés.
And those with the tendency,
et ceux
as well
qui avaient
as
des tendances,
people were called,
ainsi que les gens du peuple nouveau, ont été envoyés à la rééducation. C'est tout ce que je savais.
Who was Sao Pim?
Question. Qui était
Madame
Sao Pim?
Witness?
Madame le témoin.
I did not know who he was.
Je ne savais pas qui
il était.
J'ai simplement entendu son nom.
Do you remember what you heard about his name?
Question. Vous souvenez-vous de ce que vous avez entendu à son sujet?
People in the village talked about him, about the
dans le village, les gens parlaient de lui et de la situation confuse.
At the time, and I did not know anything else.
Je ne savais rien d'autre à part cela.
And do you remember what the villagers were speaking about? What did
question,
they say?
Vous souvenez-vous de ce que disaient les villageois? Que disaient-ils au sujet de Sao Pim? Vous en souvenez-vous?
They did not say anything else.
Réponse. Ils n'ont rien dit d'autre.
They even took place and died down and
a eu lieu,
nobody knew
et ensuite la tension est retombée, personne ne savait rien d'autre.
Do you recall
question
in which sector and in which zone
vous souvenez-vous dans quel secteur et zone se trouvait votre village entre 1975 et 1979?
It was réponse. Sector 24.
C'était le secteur 24.
And which zone
question.
Do you remember?
Et dans quelle zone, vous en souvenez-vous? Réponse.
No, I don't.
Non, je ne m'en souviens pas.
Know that it was
je sais
in
simplement
sector
que c'était
24.
Le secteur 24.
Have you ever question. Heard of someone called Heng Samrin?
Avez-vous jamais entendu parler d'un homme du nom de Heng Samrin?
Question. Je connais
son nom, mais je ne connais pas son visage.
And do you remember what you heard
vous souvenez-vous about him de ce que vous avez entendu à son
between
sujet
75 and 79
entre 75
or
et
79 thereafter?
Ou après?
Non, je ne sais rien d'autre.
Je ne sais rien d'autre. Comme je vous ai dit, j'ai simplement entendu parler de son nom.
Do you know whether there was ever any fighting going on?
Savez-vous s'il y a eu des combats?
Military troops of the Democratic Kampuchea,
du Kampuchea démocratique,
regime, the government, and Vietnamese troops. In other words, did you ever hear sounds?
Avez-vous
of
jamais
war,
entendu des
guns being,
bruits de
guns
guerre,
shooting,
des coups de feu,
cannons shooting,
des canons,
tanks shooting each other? Have you ever heard of anything like that?
Avez-vous jamais entendu cela?
No,
réponse.
I did not.
Non. Question.
My last question, Madam Witness,
is it
my understanding correct that you yourself have never witnessed in front of your eyes anyone being killed? You never saw any actual killing of anybody, is that correct?
Vous n'avez jamais été témoin d'une exécution, de qui que ce soit. Est-ce exact? Réponse.
Yes, that is correct.
Oui,
since I never saw it.
Je n'en ai jamais.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Maître Coppe, j'en ai terminé. Le président.
President, thank you, Counsel.
Merci,
it is now convenient to have a short break. We take
voilà
a break
un bon
now
moment
and
pour prendre la pause. Nous allons suspendre le débat et nous reprendrons à 10h30.
Court officer, please assist the witness and the waiting room reserved for witnesses and civil parties during the break time
prévu à cet effet
and invite her back into the courtroom at 10:30.
Et vous assurez qu'elle soit de retour dans la salle d'audience à 10h30. Suspension du débat.